Arrays are data structures used for storing a collection of values that all have the same data type. To declare an array, we begin as we would a normal variable declaration, but also append a set of square brackets. The bracket contains the number of elements in the array. The default values for these elements are the same as for variables. For global arrays, they become zero, and for local arrays, they are not initialized. To assign values to the elements, we can reference them one at a time by placing the element's index inside the square brackets, starting with 0. We can also assign values at the same time as the array is declared by enclosing them in curly brackets. The specified array length can then be left out to let the size be decided by the number of values assigned. Once the array elements are initialized, we can access them by referencing the index of the element we want. Arrays can also be made multidimensional by adding more sets of square brackets. As with single-dimensional arrays, they can either be filled in one at a time or all at once during the declaration. Because arrays are made up of non-dynamic memory, their size must be determined before execution. Therefore, the size needs to be a constant value. In order to create arrays with a variable length, we need to use dynamic memory, which is allocated with a new keyword and must be assigned to a pointer. Any array in C++ is actually a pointer to the first element in the array. The referencing of an array element can just as well be made with pointer arithmetics. By incrementing the pointer with 1, we move to the next element in the array, because changes to a pointer's address are implicitly multiplied by the size of their data type. Keep in mind that just like with any other pointer, it's possible to exceed the valid range of an array. It's therefore important to keep track of the array's length. To determine the length of a statically allocated array, we can use the sizeOf operator, but this cannot be used for dynamically allocated arrays. The only way to know the size of this array is through the variable that we used in its allocation. When we're done using a dynamic array, we must remember to delete it using the delete keyword with an appended set of square brackets.